everybody. It's really cold and gloomy. It's below zero, or I think at least zero right now. So this isn't going to be a very long reading. but Valentine's is coming. I'm going to do another love reading. I'm going to do Divine Masculine, Divine Feminine. Place yourself where you see fit, and we'll get into it. Don't mind my back seat. I just went shopping. If you see it, some new stuff for my apartment that I put a deposit in for yesterday, which I'm super excited. But I didn't buy a lot of furniture. Like, I'm just looking for the essentials, and I'm gonna decorate as I go because I don't really know exactly what my apartment looks like. They're only doing virtual tours, so we shall see. I got some good stuff though. Anyway, Divine Masculine, let's get your borrowing this for a second. Wow. It disappeared into the abyss. Did I drop one? Maybe I did. I'll find it later, I guess. It's not meant to be in this reading. So we got Virgo for Divine Masculine, Pluto, and Mars. And for Divine Feminine, we have Sagittarius, Taurus, Aquarius. We'll get into energies as well, or these could be your signs. I'm just going to lay out a quick part one, and then we'll do part two. Divine Masculine, details, feelings, details. My fingers are already cold a little bit. And I'll lean in so you can see me once I stop. Oh my god, Divine. Alright, I'll take a lot. Divine Feminine has a lot to say on this reading. Okay. So we're going to start with the Divine Masculine, and I'm just going to talk about him straight through till we run. Or, I don't mean him, because in the spiritual world, there's no room for gender. So, whoever's in the masculine energy. So we have. Sometimes I stay awake thinking about you. Definitely getting restless nights. This Divine Masculine is having trouble sleeping, dreaming about you, getting a lot of signs specifically about you. You were the best thing in my life. So this Divine Masculine is realizing maybe they made the wrong choice, or they messed up, or they should have never let you go. I'm definitely feeling this energy. We will be together again. This Divine Masculine wants a if you're in separation, they want a second chance. If you're together and it's not going well, they want a second chance. But they just know that this is fated, like you're their one. I wish I could take back my words. So, they could have did or said something to upset the Divine Feminine. They're really regretting any beef, anything that went wrong. I think they're really beating themselves up for at this time. Denying feelings. So they still could be denying their feelings for you, Divine Feminine. Or they could be denying feelings to their karmic, like still pretending that their karmic situation is good and denying that they have feelings for you. They could still be in that, ooh, I choose you. Okay, so their divine masculine here is not telling divine feminine anything. I don't think you even know divine feminine how they feel, but they are choosing you. So if they're with a karmic, they might be getting out of a situation, or they're just preparing themselves to come forward and say, I'm sorry, I messed up, I want you back, or something along those lines. We have justice coming, so divine masculine could be going through a divorce, separation, waiting for something to come, karmic justice, whatever they need to move on from what is holding them back from coming to you, that will be closing out soon. We have runner, so they could have been the one that ran away from you. And we have in your pride, so they could have ran because they had ego. They didn't want anyone to matter more than they mattered to themselves. Or they could be currently in their pride and just focused on 3D stuff. I want to get married. So yeah, the divine masculine is, I feel like this is past energy within your pride and your ego. I think that's kind of what went wrong here with the divine masculine, was listening to their ego. Could have been in karmic situations, karmic relationships. They're realizing you're the one divine feminine. They want you. They're going for you. But for some reason, they can't right now. With that justice coming in, it could be a divorce. It could be figuring out custody. It could be moving. Whatever needs to happen for you two to come together, that's what they're doing right now. They're in this for the long haul. Don't listen to the haters. So they have karmic people, or there's stuff in your way of you two coming together, and people might not want to see this come into fruition here, and they're just no longer listening to anybody. They're listening to themselves. Speak your truth. Yeah, divine masculine wants to come in and tell divine feminine their feelings, that they choose them, that they want to marry them, and tell them all the shit they've been going through. They just want to spill their guts and be like, this is what's up, this is how I feel, and this is why I couldn't tell you until now. So wow, exciting. Alright, so we have Virgo. They could be analyzing here. They could be a Virgo themselves. Pluto, they're isolating themselves and their feelings from you. They're kind of closed off from you, divine feminine. We have Mars, because they're fighting their way out of something, trying to get justice, but they're also fighting for this connection behind the scenes, out of your sight, out of your knowledge, with this Pluto energy. But I think with the analyze feelings with these Virgos, I think they already have analyzed. They already are realizing that you're the one that they want. Now, Virgo isn't just analyzing, it's also making a plan. No one makes a plan better than Virgo. So this person, this divine masculine, could be making a plan here to come forward. Alright, let's switch over to the divine feminine. What's going on here? I am becoming a better person. So divine feminine is working on spirituality, healing inner childhood wounds, working on career, working on becoming balanced, doing that spiritual work. Good for you, divine feminine. I think they're just focusing on learning lessons, taking what they need, and keeping it moving, if that makes sense. I can't stop thinking about you. Oh dear. So this divine feminine is kind of like the divine masculine. Divine masculine's over here denying their feelings, but constantly thinking about divine feminine, and you're mirroring each other. This person is focusing on their spirituality and their work. I can't stop thinking about you. So cute. I know I messed up everything. My goodness, you guys really are mirrors. You're both thinking that the other, like, divine masculine's blaming themselves, like, fuck, I fucked up, I lost my one, I was a little bit of a douche in my ego. Why did I do that? The divine feminine's over here like, I was a fucking asshole. I fucked it all up. So I gotta become better. Like, you're both attacking the fuck out of you. Why do I swear so much? I was so good all day. Now I'm swearing. Maybe divine feminine's frustrated. But you're both literally self-sabotaging. I'm starting to understand our connection. So whatever difficulties came between, I think this divine feminine is realizing because it wasn't the right time, and that you still had things to learn, which is good. Like, this person, this divine feminine is more like, I feel like Divine Masculine is getting out of stuff, closing chapters, and Divine Feminine has probably already closed some chapters, oh my god, why can't I speak? Maybe they're having throat chakra issues, but they're, like, healing from their tower moments. They're becoming more spiritually awakened, and they're understanding why things took a curveball, and forgiveness is coming here. We both know I'm not the one for you. Ooh. So this Divine Feminine, I think this is what they think you're gonna say, Divine Masculine. I just feel like the Divine Masculine is married or in a long term in this situation. And this Divine Feminine is like, I'm nothing like that person. That's not the lifestyle I want. That's not the direction I'm going. Like, they're probably a little bit comparing themselves to your karmic. Like, if this is what they like, then why would they like me? Or if something happened here and there's been no communication, they, again, just like Divine Masculine, feel like they messed it up. So they just don't feel good enough or to your standards or your type. I don't feel like it's like, we both know I'm not the one. Because I do feel like this person, with them thinking about you a lot, they have very deep feelings. They could be trying to deny their feelings to themselves. Like, no, this is not love. I don't love them. I'm fine. It could be tough love there within themselves. I feel you, even though we are apart. So yeah, you're at a distance in separation. It could be a physical distance, but they feel your energy all the time. They feel this connection very much. I think they don't like that very much. I think they're trying to move on here, to be honest. They have a karmic. Yep, exactly. So this is why Divine Feminine has retreated, ran away. They think you're a happy Divine Masculine. They have no idea you have feelings. And like I said, Divine Masculine did have denying feelings. So, of course, Divine Feminine has no idea what the hell is going on. Thinks that they have been rejected. They think they have fucked it up. They think they're not enough, not worthy. Like, Divine Masculine has kicked Divine Feminine's pride. But we have Glow Up, which triggered that glow up. It triggered Divine Feminine to go into a spiritual awakening, which is where the Divine Feminine is realizing. She's learned, like, my ego was kicked. I was angry, but this is why my ego was kicked. This is the lesson I need to learn. So she's having, I keep saying she, I don't mean to. Divine Feminine can be a man. Again, no gender here. I just accidentally say that sometimes. Inner and outer glow up. They're probably trying to work on their appearance, like a lot of people are in the beginning of the year, working on career, working on bettering themselves, just doing good over here, focusing, putting all the love that they wanted to put into Divine Masculine into themselves, which is a very positive place to be, especially if this is a twin flame journey. I don't feel good enough for you. Exactly. They feel rejected by this Divine Masculine. Like, Divine Masculine was like, ugh, peasant. Like, that's what I feel like the energy is. Like, this Divine Feminine's like, well, fine, fuck you then, I'm gonna go over here and do my own thing. But they keep looking back like, I'm not a peasant. You know, like, there's still a little bit butthurt about it, even though they are working on it. Ooh, pregnancy, birth, new start. So Divine Feminine, maybe you had children together. Maybe they had a pregnancy recently. But I just feel like this is more of birthing a new start with this glow up, like going in a new direction. They could have started a new career. They could have started a new life, moving, anything like that. A newness here with that glow up. They're doing something fun. Didn't come correct. Yeah, this Divine Masculine did not come to correct a Divine Feminine. I feel like even though Divine Feminine feels rejected, they also rejected Divine. I feel like you rejected each other because Divine Feminine wasn't feeling it. They didn't want to be second to anyone, especially if they knew you have a karmic. They were like, fuck that, I am the only one, and I'm going to pull my energy back in and until I am the only one, which good for you, Divine Feminine, but Divine Masculine, that's also part of your journey for you to get checked by Divine Feminine, and Divine Feminine, that's a part of your journey to be checked by, you check each other, which causes a spiritual awakening and a spiritual growth and makes you become better people. You make me smile. So although there's some bad blood here, if they ever see you out and about or whatever they're seeing on, you are somebody that they still feel happy about. They're rooting for you. You make them laugh. They don't hate you. There's not bad blood here. Like I said, this Divine Feminine is spiritually glowing up. You feel like home. So it did come out in reverse, but I'm not taking these in reverse because I just feel like although that what they said they feel you even though you're apart. So you're home to them. You're like a beacon. Even though they try to put you away, they can't. It's like that beacon keeps going off. Choked up with the throat chakra. Yeah, exactly. This Divine Feminine, is very protective of their energy and their feelings. And they don't trust Divine Masculine enough to speak their truth. 5D connection, but you are communicating. This is a very deep spiritual connection. Like I said, you can communicate in dreams. You could be visiting each other in sleep. I'm sorry I let you down. So Divine Feminine feels in some sense that they did something to cause you to go to someone else. Like they pushed you into someone else's arms. That's sad, Divine. No, Divine Feminine, you don't push anybody into anyone's arms. Everybody makes their own decision. And if you are a fated connection, you will come back together. Everybody has a karmic before they meet the one. It's just how it goes. All right, we have Sagittarius, Taurus, and Aquarius. So Aquarius is the star. You're the chosen one, Divine Feminine. You're the one leading the pack in the spiritual connection in this union. I feel like you are a muse to the Divine Masculine and vice versa. You very much feel like each other is your chosen one with this 11-11. You're recognizing a very deep spiritual connection and you're rooting to it. To me, this is saying you both realize you're the one, but especially Divine Feminine. Taurus, Divine Feminine is still very defensive and protective of their feelings and their energy. They don't quite trust, but they are standing firm. They are, I don't know what it is with music in these readings. It's a good Valentine's song, so. Well, I'm not doing that. They're like, shh. Maybe someone wants to kiss your eyes, Divine Feminine. It is a good Valentine's song, and it's creepy that it's up car parking. I don't know how it works up there. It freaks me out sometimes. The song haunts me. Message for you, keep listening. People, That was your Valentine's song from Spirit. Back to your reading. I mean, the words could have meant something to you. I don't even know if YouTube's going to play that. I'm sure there's royalties, but whatever. Spirit does what Spirit does. So, Sagittarius. Passion, though. They cannot deny this passion. Divine Feminine might be trying to forgive. I didn't mean to say that, so perhaps they are forgiving you. They are trying to forget you, but they can't. They have so much passion. You light them up. They try so hard to put you away, but they know at the same time you're the one. But they still honestly do think that you are happy with your karmic. All right, let's go on to part two. Divine Masculine. Some music while I do the next spread. How about that? If I can. It might just be silent. It is Saturday. Cold, it's extra crinkly. If you live in a really cold place, you know what that means. It's fucking cold. Anyway, Divine Masculine, where to start with you? We're going to do the same setup. I'm going to go all the way through Divine Masculine's cards, and then we'll go to Divine Feminine to close it out. Alright, so, we have letting go. So, again, this is the energy I feel. Fear. So, Divine Masculine could be trying to let go of some fears. Holy crap, Ola. That just flew way across the car. It said, inner knowing. They're letting go of karmic energy, toxic situations, and fears. Solitude to me is, again, that Virgo hermit energy, keeping things to themselves until what they need to let go of is done. It's like they don't want to come into the relationship incorrect this time with a bunch of baggage. So they're dealing with that. And with discernment, they're trying to judge when the right time is to come in for Divine Feminine. And with the inner knowing, again, to me, just represents that they know and feel that you are the one. I don't know if this is twin flame. I kind of feel like it is, but they haven't clarified yet. I'm just trying to make a plan. How do I come correct to this Divine Feminine Meanwhile, Divine Feminine really doesn't know what's going on. So, for the Divine Masculine, we have back and forth. Yeah, it's like maybe they haven't quite made a decision in who they're picking yet. Maybe that's where they're at in some of your connections, and I'm having a really difficult time speaking. So they could be choked up as well. But back and forth, the karmic might not be letting them go easily. And just like keeping a grip on the Divine Masculine. Back and forth could be going back and forth in their mind and like having the courage and then getting scared. It could be that as well. Deserving. They are working on their vibration and realizing that they do deserve to be happy. They do deserve a true love connection. They are trying to get out of the dark night of the soul, which is good. Great gratitude. They're very thankful for this connection because it did make them better. It did help them see. And great achievement. So, to me, this is Divine Masculine really wanting to come correct, coming as somebody that you respect, Divine Feminine, and someone that isn't going to have a bunch of immaturity and baggage and inner healing to do. But they are very thankful. I do feel like they want to give a gift here or have something solid to represent to the Divine Feminine. And they aren't going to come until they do. With this, we have Knight of Cups, the Sun. I'm going to do a couple at a time. And Queen of Swords. So they do want to make a love offer here, but they don't feel like it's the right time, or they don't feel like they have enough, or they can't offer something solid because they're not out of cleaning up their messes yet or past relationships. So they're representing, if they came in now with an offer, it wouldn't be something you deserve, but they want to. They want to make that love offer. They're fighting it. The Sun, you made them very happy. They're working on their vibration. You're the chosen one, Divine Feminine, the one they want, their end game. Queen of Swords, they are making those cuts. If they are in a relationship, they're getting out of it. This is divorce energy. Cutting those haters out that are against it. Like just getting rid of anybody that doesn't jive with your future. Including their own bad thoughts. And we have Seven of Wands, Eight of Pentacles, and the Star. You both got the Star or Aquarius on each side. So that's again representing that you're the chosen one. You're mirroring that in each other, like you are who each other wants. Eight of Pentacles, Divine Masculine, trying to make the right plan and the right choices. They want to come correct. They are also protecting their feelings and their energy. They're not coming until they're ready, until they can really impress and have something solid. This is them also keeping those haters at a distance. They're trying to make the right choices. They're trying to clean up their mess and do so correctly and quickly. They are seeing the truth. They're just not telling their truth. And they want to come correct to the Divine Feminine as this, again, Earth Energy, King of Pentacles, solid, someone they trust, someone that they look up to. So it's like they're transforming themselves to become better and to become the one the Divine Feminine would choose. All right, Divine Feminine over here, we have Mystery. Yeah, they don't know how the Divine Masculine feels, what they want. They have no idea that the Divine Masculine is making a plan, that they're getting out of a relationship. They have no idea how they feel in their heart. They're left out in the dark. But they are trusting the Divine because they are spiritual, so they're trusting that this connection isn't quite finished and that something will come out of it. And we have Turn Away. Yeah, they've turned away. They've pulled their energy back. They're trying to move on. But like I said, they keep looking back at you like, I can't get over you, Divine Masculine. They're trying, but they can't. They do see an abundant life with you. You are their happiness. You are the one that they want, whether they're saying it or not, even to themselves. A creative endeavor. So they could be working on something artistic here, or maybe they want to work with you and collaborate. It could be that as well. Kindred partnership. Yeah, they see you as their one, their soulmate, the love of their life. So, which is even more of a mystery. Like, how could they feel this and it be nothing? You know what I mean? With the status quo, they're also trying to be enough for you. They could be working on themselves. They could be just, they want to impress you. They want to be, but not like for faulty or materialistic reasons. It's like they too want to be someone that you respect. They're going through a lot of conflict, or this is representing that there's conflict in the way here that they're dealing with. I just think they have conflict in their life as well. Divine Masculine's over here cleaning up their mess, and I think Divine feminine is also in that energy, they could be having some turmoil with any of their situations that they were closing out as well. So divine feminine has a lot of anxiety about this. I think they make it worse in their mind. They are blaming themselves, nitpicking themselves because they don't feel worthy of you. They feel rejected. So there's a lot of anxiety here. Then we have Knight of Pentacles. They are trying to move on. They are trying to move away from you and collect their feelings back. But like I said, they keep looking back at you. They know that they planted seeds and they have a feeling that those seeds are going to sprout one day, but they're just trying to me with this Ace of Pentacles, they're trying to move on and plant new seeds and just keep going because they don't want to just sit and wait in this mystery. Like, they're trying to get out of their dark night of the soul as well. The Magician, they are trying to manifest answers here. They want to know the truth. They want to know what this connection is. I think they're sensing that Divine Masculine has feelings because this person is very spiritual. Eight of Cups, yeah, they do feel rejected. Like, the Divine Masculine walked away from their bowl here. The bowl wasn't enough. They weren't enough for the Divine Masculine, and they're feeling that they will get rejected again if they tried. They're very defensive of their feelings, and they still are defensive of you. They're very protective of you, despite the broken heart I kind of feel here. And we have Two of Pentacles. Although they're trying to move on, they're still juggling their feelings for you. They're still juggling, why can't I let this go? What is this connection? Like, they very much question this a lot. Like, if this person isn't my one, and if I'm not meant to be, or whatnot, why can't I forget? Why can't I move on? This is what's going on in the Divine Feminine's mind. So, to end the reading, sorry, I need heat. Can't leave my car to cool down too much. Okay. In the near future, what advice does the Divine Masculine need for this connection? If they are the Divine Masculine watching, what advice do you need from Spirit in this love situation? Eight of Pentacles, the Star, Queen of Swords. Keep doing what you're doing. Try to use your instincts and ask Spirit for signs and follow your intuition to do what's best for you and what you want. Follow your Northern Star, which is your intuition. Follow your gut, follow your heart, and make those cuts to the people that don't suit you, but don't serve you. And I think you're realizing that, and that's what you're doing. Basically, Spirit's saying keep doing what you're doing. Stay positive. Stay in one direction. No more back and forth. You got to cut that out. You got to make a choice here. They're really pushing you to make a choice between this karmic Three of Cups in reverse. Upright, it's a positive collaboration. It's celebrating, like, whoever you're collaborating with isn't going well for you. So Spirit's like, look at the signs. Look at what's going on and pay attention. See the lessons and things. All right, Divine Feminine, what advice do you need for this connection? We have Ten of Pentacles. You're looking for stability, but you don't need anyone, Divine Feminine, to make you stable. You are the stability within yourself. You already have pulled your energy back, and you're working on self-love, and you're working on your confidence, and that takes time. But you don't need anyone. You don't need this Divine Masculine to be stable within yourself. So I think this is a thought you need to work on. Your confidence, being good on your own, which takes time here. The Hierophant in reverse. Don't ever, including the Divine Masculine, don't give your energy and your heart to someone who's only halfway in. You deserve better than that. If it's meant to be, they're going to come correct, and I feel like this Divine Masculine will come correct. But don't say yes to any sort of commitment until they do. And you haven't received what you needed to move on. Like, you still have a lot of questions. You haven't received what you need to become the Hierophant upright. You still have a lot of spiritual healing to do. They're recognizing that you are working on that. But I think not having closure in this has hung up some of your spirituality. So I think what they're trying to say is focus. You're not going to get the answers you need right now from your Divine Masculine. So you need to look for the answers within yourself. Why are you so dependent on this relationship? Why do you need it in your heart space so much? What are you lacking within your life that... I mean, it's okay to think about this person, because I think we all, in divine feminine, divine masculine connections, you're always going to think of each other, but I just feel like there's a little bit of codependency in a spiritual sense, and spirit's asking you to look at that, because that's a roadblock in this. All right, for the two of you in the future, Ten of Pentacles upright. See, Divine Feminine, you're going to work it out. You're going to get that stability. They're going to come correct, and this will be a solid connection. When you do come together, if you both follow your instincts, if you both do the work, it's going to be something solid and long-term. But right now, you are in separation, and you can't come together until you're both solid. So this is why the separation is happening right now. They're answering some questions. Yeah, you're not happy without each other. You're not, like, upright. This would be perfect union, Ten of Cups. So to me, it's saying, Spirit's like, you're not in union. You're both realizing at this time that you're each other's one. You're not happy, and it's coming in the future. Do something about those feelings now. And what you do about those feelings need to come from you, so they're not going to give you too much advice at this time about it. But I hope they did give you some details that are going to help you progress in this, and I hope they gave you some answers that you needed. And I will see you all again soon. I need to get moving before I freeze, and the cemetery is creepy right now. Love you all. Bye.